Wow. I think there's a lot of people that are going to be listening to this right now going, I didn't know that Freddie Prinze Jr. worked for WWE. Well, what made you even want to start working there?
I grew up loving pro wrestling. And I just, you know, I knew that I could write. I don't want to sound arrogant, but I knew I could write well, okay? And I knew I could write well for talent. And I knew that I could hear them speak and write words that they would say instead of what sounded good in my head that I would say. Mm. And that's a hard disconnect for a lot of wrestling writers to make. And it's a step that television writers have to be able to make. Screenwriters have to be able to make. If all your characters sound like one writer wrote them, you failed. You failed. If the wrestler you're writing for sounds like you, you failed. You failed the wrestler. The writer's job is one per, and it's only 10% of the equation, right? Like it's 80% on the wrestler. It's 15% booking and it's 5% writing, right? Like I've seen horrible promos get over because the talent's so money, right? But you know, I get sidetracked a lot when I talk wrestling because I really do care about it. But I knew that if I just sat with them, I could. Here's the best example. MVP was at the, who's now holding Raw together by himself, basically, him and Alexa Bliss. So he was doing a promo against Jeff. They had a match coming up. And he was writing a promo with Krista Joseph. Chris won't mind me saying this. And it wasn't working. Like they were both trying to figure it out. They had 100 notes from Vince that screwed them all up and 100 other notes from other people. It's just too many cooks in the kitchen, right? And I'm kind of sitting in the cut, just kind of like spying on them, right? And MVP hated me, did not want to speak to me, right? More than Cena. Cena didn't like me to the very end, right? And he was like, hey, that was a really good promo. And I just no-sold it. I was like, yeah, whatever. But MVP hated me. And he was a legit wow. dude, right? So I'm hesitant to go up because I already know like his feelings about me, but I already knew how to fix the promo. Like I had already written it in my head. I heard what the problem was and I just knew. And so I was like, screw it. I'm going over. If I get in a fight, I get in a fight. If I get beat up, I get beat up. I've been beat up before. So I go over there and I say, hey guys, I know I'm interrupting. I think I got this. And I just acted it out. I freestyled it right there. Right. And he looks at me and his look went from like, I'm going to kill you to hold up. Wait, say that last part again. Is that what he says to me? And so now I already got I got him on the hook. I just got to reel him in and not pull too hard. Right.
He's the hungry bass now.
So I cut the line again, but I cut it as if I told you I'm good with voices. So I do this MVP voice. Right. And I cut it like he cuts it. And I go, you could take that as a line reading or you could take it as, you know, inspiration, make it yours. I go, but I really think that'll help you. And he goes out and he cuts the promo and he kills it. I mean, kills it. And Vince went from not looking at him that highly in just a moment to all of a sudden going, wow, this guy's sick on the mic. This is the guy that I originally signed. I forgot he could do this. And I started, you know, getting a little bit of love from the guys after. I didn't tell Vince I wrote it. I said that him and DJ did it. And that got me some love from DJ and from him. You know, that business is all about passing, knowing when to pass credit and knowing when to not let people take your credit, right?
Yeah.
So if it's a small thing, it's always like, nah, man, it's them. And if it's a big thing and people are trying to screw it up, that's when you got to step in and go, Vince, when I conceptualized this alone in the first place, the idea that you liked, this is what we discussed. And we're getting sidetracked now because you're letting other people's opinions on this wrestler get involved with the creative process. And sometimes I would win that argument. More often than not, I would lose that argument because he goes with what he knows and he goes with who he knows. And he has a history with those men and he didn't have a history with me. So my victories were always surprising in the production office. And I had more than most, but it was always an uphill battle, always.
Hey, it's Chris. And thank you so much for checking out this video on my CVV Clips channel. If you haven't subscribed yet, I'd be so grateful if you could do that right now. Don't worry, the main channel is not going anywhere. We've got full in-depth interviews on the Chris Van Vliet channel. CVV Clips is for exactly that, clips from those longer interviews.